Yeah, my name is Ed Allen. I'm general manager of North America for industrial products industrial industries for IBM. We've always been able for the last several years to be able to connect and collect data and to be able to analyze data. Now what's new, what's coming out, is the ability to be able to, you know, run cognitive systems on top of that data, to be able to do things like machine learning and using artificial intelligence to be able to help individual operators take optimal decisions. And so the big changes that that will drive will be within individual operations, they'll be able to operate more efficiently, we'll see significantly higher quality, and we'll empower the people that are working in these locations to be able to have both information and the ability to be able to act on that information at a significantly higher level. Yeah, there's a few things. One is that, you know, if we take a look at where manufacturers are today, and in the domain of manufacturing specifically, there's an opportunity to be able to take on, you know, leverage these new technologies to be able to do things that like visual inspection, where typically you have operators that have to go through and visually inspect, you know, material products and parts as they're being manufactured. And part of that, there's an art to it, right? And there's a talent that's developed over a period of time. And when a human is doing that, it takes, you know, a significant amount of time and expertise to be able to go and identify potential defects. If you can automate those types of things, right, through visual inspection and cognitive systems that can train and learn, that you can train and can learn to identify defects, you can do it at a much more rapid pace. You can do it at a much more reliable pace. And the thing is that they will be able to, you know, give sort of individual humans at that point sort of the power, exponential power, to be able to help to, you know, to be able to identify those types of defects. So, you know, quality increases at that point, and as well as throughput and reliability. We at IBM are taking this as a collective view. We're taking a look at, you know, at what's called either brilliant manufacturing or Industry 4.0 or the factory of the future, and decomposing that into sort of an umbrella of initiatives called cognitive manufacturing. And within cognitive manufacturing, we spend a lot of time and effort and energy taking new technologies that are developing, things like artificial intelligence and, you know, capabilities around machine learning and blockchain, for example, and decomposing cognitive manufacturing into a set of precise use cases that have been proven in the market across the board, where we have live clients that have already deployed some of this stuff, and create go-fast models in those domain areas. And so if we deconstruct that into 15 individual use cases and have that as a part of cognitive manufacturing, the go-fast model helps us to be able to stand up useful use cases that can drive, you know, utility immediately, and use that as a part of a continuum to be able to drive a more significant transformation.